Are you sad that you have to make your game look more like this just to maintain around 30 to 40 frames? Well, you've come to the right place because I'm going to help you make your game look more like this while still holding a higher and smoother frame rate. So stick around and let's get right into it. Alrighty guys, well we're going to get right into this and we're going to start off by going to our in-game settings. So first things first, turn off maximum frame rate. You don't need that. The more frames you can get, the better. And motion blur, those two, they can get out of here. We don't like those, right? So we're going to snap over here. And I would very much so play around with your resolution scale. I'm going to turn mine to 100 because I feel like I can run it due to the frames that I'm going to be able to get out of this. But I would play around with that. 80 looks fine too. And when it comes to graphics, as far as textures, between advanced graphics and textures, if you've got a good enough GPU, really don't need to set that any lower. You can set it to high if you want to. As for anti-aliasing, you can leave that at about medium. And for view distance, low and medium, they do just fine. As far as post-processing goes, medium and low are just fine. General shadows, now this very much so affects the performance of your computer. Setting it to low will give you a lot of frames back, but also decrease the quality of your shadows in the game. So if you really care about your shadows and you want to take away some frames for them, feel free and you can mess around with those. As far as global illumination goes, this one doesn't affect it too much. Playing around with medium and high shouldn't be bad. Effects quality. Now this has a big impact on your computer. So I suggest setting y'all's to medium or low. If you have the same thing as me, like a 4070 Ryzen 9 5900X, you should be fine. Foliage quality, the lower the better. As far as light bloom, light shafts, low light enhancement, and enable foliage and fluid interaction, you can go ahead and just take all of those off and you'll be good to go. As far as foliage interaction distance multiplier goes, the lower the better. I suggest keeping it at 2:1:1. So if that works for you, you can give that a shot. That granted me quite a few frames as well. Enable footstep particles and footstep decals. If you want to squeeze a few more frames in there, you can go ahead and turn these off as well. And you can go to RTX over here. If you've got an RTX card, 20 series and up, you can go ahead and turn on DLSS. And then for super resolution, set it to performance or ultra performance. I keep mine on performance. And then for frame generation, if you've got a 4000 series, turn this on. It does wonders. Now we're going to go ahead and switch over to camera. And there's two in here that I do like to play around with between camera view bob and camera shake scale. View bob, I turn off because I don't like my head bouncing around as I run. And camera shake scale, I turn that to zero because personally, I don't like my entire screen looking like it's in a rock tumbler whenever a brontosaurus comes walking by me. And then for FOV, I set that to about 75. Now this is preference. You can set it higher if you want to. It will increase your perspective. But the issue with that is the wider you can see, the more frames you're going to lose because you're loading in more things to see at the same time. I'm going to go ahead and leave mine at 75, which I think is a pretty good number. So we're going to go ahead and save. Okay, I'm getting about 80 FPS compared to what I was on medium graphics. And as you guys could see, I had a lot of stuff on Epic. So there was quite a few key things in there that really boosted the FPS. That's only the first step of what I got for you guys. There's two more settings that we're going to try that are very simple and yet incredibly beneficial. So the first one, you're gonna go ahead and open up your console by hitting the tilde key, which is the little squiggle next to the one. And you're going to type r.volumetric cloud space 0. Now I'm gonna set it to 1 real quick and look up so you guys can see exactly what it does. 1 is the default, so if you don't like it, you can turn it back on by setting it to 1. But if you set it to 0, it essentially just redoes the skybox and makes it look a lot more simple. Still looks fairly nice, honestly. And that just gave me around 20 frames per second. And then the other thing is volumetric fog. Now, I'm going to look over there and you'll probably be able to see it better. But if you turn off volumetric fog, you go from 1 to 0, it starts to look like that. So it kind of removes the kind of intuitive, the foggy effect that Ark has. And it does remove a lot of depth to the terrain, but that does generally help your frames, but it kind of just depends on your system. So if this doesn't work for you and anything works against your frames, go ahead and just turn that back on. Use whatever works best for you as a a lot of getting these settings right is actually just up to your system. Next part that I have for you guys today is going to be a list of other values that you can play around with. I'm not going to play around with them because they are all more so towards very, very, very low-end PCs, but I will go ahead and leave a link to those commands in the description. But yeah, so we're going to go ahead and kick off to the next thing, which is going to be in the launch options of Steam. Alrighty, guys, and last but not least, we have one more thing to add to the list, and that is to change your launch options. So you're going to go ahead to your Steam library, click Properties, and go to General, and right here where it says Advanced Users may choose to enter modifications to their launch options, I want you guys to go ahead and enter the code that is going to be down in the description, and we're going to go ahead and paste that in there. And with this, it is going to essentially unlock your VRAM completely, unlock your CPU completely, and then also force the game to have no FPS cap and force no VSync as well. So basically a pretty good loadout of things, and we'll go ahead and pop right back into the game and show you guys what it looks like now. Alrighty, guys, well, we are back in the game now, and as you guys can see, it is looking fairly smooth. I'm actually gonna go ahead and pop out a cinematic camera and just kind of walk around a little bit. I'm getting a steady 70 to 80 frames right now with resolution scale 100. I was able to get that up. But yeah, so I think the game looks absolutely amazing now, and given I do have much higher settings than you guys might have at the moment, but at least you guys are getting 60 frames by now. So if this did help you guys out, I would love to hear what you have to say down in the comments and what you had to change and what you were able to keep. And also on top of that, if this did help you, I would greatly appreciate it if you guys could leave a like on the video, because not only would that support me, but that would also help this video get pushed out to people who might also need it. So thank you guys very much for stopping in, and I hope you guys have a wonderful night.